am in online series of machine design myself, Anisha Goswami. So in today's lecture, we will discuss around different types of laws used in gearbox. Okay. First of all, what is gearbox? Application of gearbox. Then we will see that different types of progression laws used in gearbox. Okay. So first of all, what is gearbox? So gearbox is in automobile generally when we require high torque, for example, when we require to climb hills, right? So starting torque is required very very high, right? And when we will just run on road, so torque will be less, right? So this is the first comparison, right? So when we require higher torque, so how will we increase the torque? So that function is governed by your gearbox, right? So when running at higher speed on level roads, okay, so higher torque is not required when we will just move on roads, or vehicles will run on roads, right, as compared to your hilly areas. So requirement of device is occurred due to requirement of higher torque or to require to change the vehicle's torque and its speed according to requirement, according to road condition. Okay, so that's why we require gearbox. So this device is known as gearbox are also known as your transmission box and transmission device. Okay, so gearbox are also referred as transmission unit because in that unit we will use different types of gears and we will combine different types of gear at one place, right? And change the speed or change the torque according to your requirement, or we can or it's also used to provide speed and torque conversion from a rotating power source to another device. So this is basic function. Okay, so gearbox are employed to convert input from a higher speed power to lower speed. Okay, for example, lift cranes, okay, and crushing machines, or into a many of the speeds, for example, your lathe machine, milling machine, automobile, CNC machine, right? So these are the various devices where we require your gearbox. Depend on requirement of your torque and requirement of your power. So there are different types of gearbox boxes are available. First is your single stage gearbox, and second one is your multi-stage gearbox. Okay, so first of all, we will see here what is single stage of gearbox. Okay, so a gearbox that convert a high speed into a single output. Okay, means one conversion of high speed is required into a single output. So it is called as single stage gearbox. Okay, so it's generally used two gears and shaft. Okay. So next is your multi-speed gearbox. So a gearbox which is used to convert high speed into a number of different types of output speeds, right? So that is known as your multi-speed gearbox. Okay, so multi-speed gearbox has more than two gears and shaft. So means there is gear will be more than of your two gears. Okay, and number of gears used are also according to that we will use number of shaft. Okay, so multi-speed gearbox reduces the speed in different stages. Means it will increase the speed according to your requirement, and it will also reduce the speed according to your requirement. Next is your progression laws. So there are different type of progression laws are used. So first is your different types of progression laws are used. So that is your AP, arithmetic progression, geometric progression, and harmonic progression. So first of all, what is the need of your progression laws? Okay, so progression laws are generally used to find different speed steps that we have discussed in multi-speed gearbox, that input will be converted in several numbers of output. So how will we use laws should be used to conversion of that type of requirement or fulfill that type of requirement? So it is that's why we require different types of progression laws. Okay. Next, so to find out different types of speed steps and to find out relation of two speed steps. For example, there are 10 speed steps are available. So what is the relation between every successive speed step? So that relation is find out by using different types of laws. Okay. So different types of laws are basically three types of laws are there. Arithmetic progression. So that is short form is AP. And second one is your geometric progression, short form is GP, and third one is your harmonic progression. So this is that is your HP, harmonic progression, right? So, so these are the different types of laws. So we will discuss one by one. So first of all, here this you can see here this one machine, 2D structure of machine I have taken here. So what is cutting speed? Okay, so cutting speed you can see here that if rotation of shaft or speed is known as your cutting, rotation of your cutting tool is known as your cutting speed. So you can see here, this is directly, this is totally depend on your diameter. If diameter will be high, then your speed will be low. So, or you can say that speed and diameters are inversely proportional to each other. Here you can see here, I have just used multi-stage gearbox. So that multi-stage is will be used to conversion of one input to that several types of output. Okay. So your rotational speed is inversely proportional to your diameter. So what is the velocity or linear velocity? So linear velocity is equal to pi dn by 1000. Why I am considered divided by 1000? Okay. So this speed is meter per minute. You can see here. I have written here meter per minute. Okay. So that's why I didn't divide it by 60, right? So pi dn, d, when we will consider d will be taken in mm, so here to conversion of mm into meter, we have to divide it the 1000. 1 meter is equal to 1000 mm, okay? So v is equal to pi dn by 1000, okay? So operations are always carried out at specific cutting speed. So that cutting speed is denoted by V, and it is also depend upon D and N. Okay. So N is here spindle speed. D is your diameter of workpiece at cutting location. So N is equal to 1000 V divided by pi D. So by using this relation, you can find out N. Second, next is your arithmetic progression. So, what is the arithmetic progression? So, first of all, understood the basic parameters which are used in arithmetic progression. So, first is your Z. Z is denote your total speed steps on a spindle. Okay. So, for example, if there are different types of speed steps, N1, N2, N3, N4, N1, Nz minus 1, Nz and so on. Okay. So, Z is equal to total number of speed steps, right? N. Difference between any two successive speed, we consider that AP. Okay. Next is AP is equal to, this is common difference between successive, any two successive speed. For example, difference between N1, N2, difference between N3, N2 and so on. So that constant will be remain, that difference will be remain constant. So this type of progression is known as your arithmetic progression. Next is your speed ratio. So that is denoted by pi. And ratio of any two successive speed is known as your speed ratio. So pi is equal to N2 divided by N1. And you can say that N3 divided by N2, N4 divided by N31 and so on. Okay, so this is your speed ratio. So arithmetic progression, for example, I have considered here N max is your Nz means last speed is your maximum speed. And minimum speed is your first speed. So, if N1 is equal to N min and N2 is equal to N1 plus 80, so N3 is equal to N2 plus 80, right? N3, so you can find out N1 plus 280 and what is the N4? So, N4 is equal to N3 plus 80. So, this is equal to N1 plus 380, right? So, similarly, we will find out Nz. So, Nz is equal to N1 plus Z minus 1 into 80, right? So, what is the common difference? The common difference is equal to Nz minus N1 divided by Z minus 1. So, by using this standard formula, you can find out common difference. Now, I have considered here N maximum speed 445 RPM, minimum speed 35 RPM. total number of sphere steps is equal to 12 and the cutting speed is equal to 20 meter per minute. Okay, so by using this relation you can find out at AT is equal to N2 minus 1, B is equal to 1000 V by pi N. Okay, and here difference in diameter is range V2 minus V1, similarly V3 minus V2 and so on, right? So by using this analysis you can find out different speed steps, spindle speed, phi, decay and tail decay. Okay, so by using this relation you can see here arithmetic progression is poor in low spindle speed range and it is reductant speed steps, means here our speed steps are very very less as compared to required. So at low spindle speed diameter range is wide, hence needs to add more speed steps that steps between calculated value we have seen in already table. Or at high spindle speed diameter range is very narrow. Okay, so some speed steps are reductant. Okay, so thank you, keep watching.